being said, let's move. March it out here. We've got 30 minutes of barre together. For our practice today, I've got weights, I've got a ball, and I have a lower resistance booty band. All of those are totally not necessary. You can do this without weights, without the ball, without the band. Glad you guys are here. March it out here for another 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We'll take goalpost arms, twist at the trunk. Good job, you guys. So soups. I also love a fresh veggie soup. Go to the farmer's market, get what you can. So good. Letting it simmer in the crock pot or on the stove all day. So good. All right, 5, 4, 3. We'll take some lateral lunges in 2 and 1. Good. Take a nice wide stance. We'll just go side to side. Got a little music going in the background here. Maybe you've got some favorite music at home. Good. One more to each side, and we'll come into some narrow squats here. Just drop it down, bring it back up. For 5, we'll go with mid stance squats in 4, 3, 2, and 1. Step it out a little bit here and drop it down. Good. Find your full range of motion. That's different for everyone. 5, 4, 3. Going wide in 2 and 1. Here we go. Nice and wide. Down. Good. 5, 4, 3. Keeping the chest tall and proud in 2 and 1. Good. All right. Find some figure eights. Please take water as you need it. Really important to stay hydrated. Yeah, let's just take some arm circles forward. Good, backwards. Again, your range of motion is exactly where you need to be. Swings in front. You like my new camera angle? I was like, no one's here. Let's change this up a little bit. Good. All right, find those weights. And again, if you don't have weights, grab soup cans or do this without weights. Take a few shoulder rolls, squeeze them up, and then release down and back. Good. One more time. Excellent. Hands facing the thighs. Little tiny bend in the knees. I want you to keep belly nice and tight. Okay. Raise them up. Squeeze them back. Reach them forward and raise them down, or lower them down. Counterintuitive to raise them down, right? Good. Lift them up. Squeeze the shoulder blades at the back here. Then reach forward, lower down. When you reach them forward, I encourage you to think about spreading the shoulder blades. Yeah, you've got it. Good work. So shoulder blades pull together at the back here and spread apart when we reach forward. It's almost like our push-up range of motion. Good. Let's take 3 more. I'm already feeling it in my shoulders. Maybe you are too. That's 3, 2, two, last one here. Good. Lift them up here. We're gonna squeeze them back and reach them forward and just stick with that single motion. Squeeze them back and reach them forward for five. This is four. Whoo, feeling it. And my traps and my shoulder blades. Oh, three. Good. Two. And one. Good. All the way up. Good goal post. Feel a little bit of sweet relief there. Rotate our cuff here. Rotate it down and up. For 10. We take a little break after this. Nine. Eight. So keeping our 90 degree bend at the elbow joint, just moving at our shoulder joint here. Lost count, five, let's call that five. Four, three, two, and one. Release, fold, drop the weights, maybe bring hands to where you need a little bit of love. So that's where I felt this. So I wonder if I had a little bit of tension here. I want you to really think about long neck. Sometimes when we're trying to compensate, we come up here and then everything gets tight. So let's interlace the hands, just draw the knuckles down, open up the chest, maybe take head side to side to just find some length. Good. These circles, my hands are really sore already. All right, grab your weights once again. We'll come into some back work, a little bit more back work, and then tricep work. So squeezing the elbows in here, and I'm gonna show you from the side. So I want you to avoid this, any thrusting of the low ribs. Keep everything tucked in nice and tight. So my elbows are pulling towards one another. Not a huge range of motion here. Just little squeezes in, fingers, no death grip on those weights. You've got it. Again, a little bend in the knees, squeezing the shoulder blades. Good. 10, 9, 8. You've got it. 7, 6. Strong back muscles here. 5, 4, 3. Yes, you can. 2, and 1, hold the elbows in and just pulse the hands back. You got it. For 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good. Keeping that 90 degree bend here, what we're going to do is bring the elbows nice and high. Here for our tricep work, we're taking a deeper bend in the knees, a little bit more of a hinge at the hips. And I want you to keep your gaze straight out ahead. So I'm gonna look at you just because I'm looking at the camera, but here's where we wanna go. So 90 degree bend, find it and extend. Back to 90 degrees and extend. Good, you guys, you got it. And maybe you take your practice in front of a mirror just to see where your body is in space. I get to watch myself on camera so I can see. That's not 90 degrees, Kristen. Good. So with this coming to 90 degrees and extend, we have the ability to not release the tricep muscles. So we're keeping them engaged the entire time for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Excellent. Send them back. Palms are facing one another. Squeeze them in for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So hard. Good. Palms to the sky. Lift it up for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. Yes, you can. Stay with me. 4, 3, 2, 1. Good. Arms are going to move together here. We're going to sweep them all the way up to the sky in front and then sweep them all the way back. This should feel pretty good. Just a nice slow movement here. Good, let's take one more reach all the way up. One more reach all the way back and little lifts for five, four, three, two, one. Squeeze the hands in towards one another for five, four, three, two, one. Back to full range for five, four, almost there, three, two, hurts so good, one. Whew. All right, drop those weights. Let's take the arms up overhead, take a tricep stretch. Excellent work. Find some movement and take it off to the other side. Good. And we'll reach both arms up overhead, interlace the hands, release the pointer fingers. Just take a little side movement here. Often when I'm teaching and I'm feeling things in my body, that's where I kind of lead you in our practice. So I hope this feels maybe good in your body too. Good. Let's just bring the hands down at the sides. Give our arms a little bit of a rest. Good. And maybe you take some bigger circles. Just let this movement feel good in the spine. Good. Reach both arms up once again. Let's take this to a forward fold. Inhale for a halfway lift here. And we'll step it back to our downward facing dog. Let this feel good in your hamstrings. Notice how strong you are in your shoulders, your biceps, your triceps. Good. Let's roll it forward to high plank here. You've got it. And just a nice strong hold here for 10. Don't forget to keep breathing. 9, 8. You got it. 7, 6, 5. Remember, this could be down on your knees as well. 4, 3, 2, 1. Good. Tabletop. Bring the knees down. Just invite some movements here. Maybe child's pose feels better in your body. Maybe you're like me and you want to drink water. Good. Feel empowered to take exactly what you need in this very moment. And it should look different for all of us, right? We have different bodies. Yep, kind of feeling this in my body today. All right, let's find our down dog. So if you're in child's pose, come through tabletop. Let's meet in downward facing dog. Take a full breath in. Nice big exhale out. Walk the feet to the hands. Let's find a halfway lift. I want you to feel the hamstrings here. So we're almost working to reach the crown of the head and the tailbone in opposite directions, okay? So really finding lots of length, especially right in where the hamstring connects into the glutes. I'm feeling it. I don't know about you. Good. Let's come back down to our forward fold. Inhale, let's rise and bring the hands to the heart. Grab something that resembles this, a Pilates ball, in between the thighs. You could also take a playground ball if you have that, or a small pillow, or roll up a hand towel, place that, or just glue the thighs together. Not literally, but you know, metaphorically. Good. All right, squeeze those inner thighs. Let's just lift the heels and bring them down to a hover, okay? Not setting the heels back down, starting to feel out our balance. Lift and lower. So maybe we should even do a recipe share for this question of the day. What is your favorite soup? So in high school, my husband used to work at a country club, so he did a lot of the cooking, which included a lot of soups. So he doesn't really have recipes. He just kind of throws things in and it turns out really, really good. Good. Let's take that for five. Fueling our calves here, waking them up. This is three, two, one. Good. I want you to find a kind of somewhere in between. So not super, super high heels and not little like kitten heels or whatever they're called, kind of in between here. So heels are off the ground. Let's bend the knees and lift. So just bending at the knees, like we're sliding down the wall behind us. Heels stay lifted. If that doesn't feel good in your body, keep the heels on the mat. Good. This really challenges your balance, so find a focal point. Keep that squeeze with the inner thighs for five. Four, three, two, and one. All right. Gotta go low, my friends. Go low here. Keep that squeeze on the ball. Pulse it down for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, one, hold it low, squeeze the ball for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. So bad, but so good. 4, 3, 2, 1. All the way up, lower those heels, take the ball out. Whew, just set the ball down for a brief moment. We're gonna take a quick quad stretch. Good. So I'm stretching into my left knee. I'm bringing my left knee back to meet my right. Good, off to the other side, left foot plants. Whew. Great work. Just under 10 minutes left. This might be more of like a 25 minute bar express class. Good, all right, move these out of the way just so you can see my feet here. Heels are going to be in, toes are out. And heels can be a little bit apart here. I just want you to lift and lower, lift and lower. Working to strengthen into our ankles, our feet. Again, here, we're just bringing the heels back to a hover. Good. Five, four. Everything is nice and strong here. Three, two, and one. Good. Scoot the feet in just a little bit. Let your heels touch, toes out. When we lift the heels here, heels are glued together. Bend the knees and straighten. Good. Keep the heels pushing in towards one another. Keeps the inner thighs or calves fired up for five, four. You got it. Three, two, one. Excellent. Go low here. Pulse it down for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. Maybe arms come out. Five. Four, three, heels are glued together, two, one. Stay low, pulse the knees back for time. Nine, eight, go a little lower. Six, five, four, three, two, one. Whew, yes, lower. All right, find some hip circles, drink some water. Whew. Yes, we're gonna come down to hands and knees. heart rate. So notice what happens with your body here. And maybe it's because I'm moving and talking. Whew, friends, let me know how this feels for you. Reach it up, hinge at the hips, forward fold. Half lift. Excellent. Come to tabletop here. Going to do a bit of glute work. So you've got an option. If you don't have a ball at home, you could take a weight behind the knee. And what we're going to do is lift it up, okay? I'll show you with the ball. Takes a little bit more work to get in there. Squeeze it. Good. And lift. Flex the foot here. We're just going to pulse the foot up towards the sky. So left knee is down, right foot is moving. Good. Keep that squeeze on the ball or squeeze on the weight. Here for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Keep it lifted. Pulse or squeeze on the ball for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hold the squeeze. Bring the right knee back to meet the left and lift for 5, 4, 3, 2. You got it. And 1. Excellent. Bring that down. Set it off to the side, maybe. Child's pose, maybe just a little bit of movement. And prepare other side. Whatever you've got goes behind the left knee. Right knee is directly underneath the right hip. Lift the left. Good. And we've just got little pulses up. Flex into the foot. Like we're trying to stamp your foot on your ceiling for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. Almost there. Home stretch. 3, 2, 1. Hold. Hold it up. And squeeze. Pulse on that ball or weight for 10, 9. Feel your hammy fire up. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Moving our knee in 1. Good. Hold it in. Bring the left knee back to meet the right for 5, 4. You got it. Almost there, you guys. 3, 2, 1. Ooh. Remove it. Let's find child's pose. Sink the hips back, lengthening the glutes, the thighs. Ooh. All right, come on up from your child's pose. We're going to move to a figure 4. You could take this in a seat or you could take this on your back. Yes, good work. I look like I have an epic plant coming out of my head right now. Ooh, feel this in the glutes. Good, bring that foot down, other leg up. Great job, you guys. Good. Let's take the soles of the feet together. Let the knees up and wide. Hinge at the hips. Well, I might be messaging some of you guys that were once early risers with me saying, let's get up together. Let's do this. Good. Soles of the feet to the mat. Let's just windshield wiper all the way from one side to the other. Full range of motion in our hips. Good. We'll just bring the legs off to the side. Come on up to a standing forward fold here. So hips come nice and high. Head is heavy. Let's find a halfway lift. Back down to forward fold. Inhale, rise. Exhale, hands to heart. Thank you.